students, today we are going to do the revision as UT2 is approaching. According to the UT2 syllabus, two chapters, organization of data and presentation of data, it's coming from your stats book. So today in this lecture we will revise this organization of data and presentation of data. Later on we will do revision of microeconomics also in another video. So let's start with organization of data. Now in organization of data, organization means we are distributing data among different categories. So first topic is classification of data. The process of grouping data according to their characteristics is known as classification. Now what are the objectives, क्या objectives होते हैं, क्यों हम data को classify करते हैं? क्योंकि ये simplify करता है हमारे complex data को. दूसरा, it facilitates understanding. Classify करने से हमारा data easily understandable बन जाता है. Then two, facilitate comparison. We can compare it easily if the data has been classified. Then to make analysis and interpretation easy. क्लासिफाइड डेटा पे एनालिसिस और इंटरप्रिटेशन करना ईजी होता है. द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट इज टू अरेंज एंड पुट द डेटा अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर कॉमन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स. लाइक मीन्स वी कैन पुट डेटा टुगेदर अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर ट्रेड्स, अकॉर्डिंग टू द क्वालिटीज ऑफ द डेटा. नाउ स्टेटिस्टिकल सीरीज, इंडिविजुअल सीरीज, these are the series inside this chapter. Individual series, frequency series. Individual series, raw data. Individual series, discrete series, continuous series. And this continuous is further in inclusive and exclusive series. So first of all, data can be individually presented in two forms, raw or individual series. So data collected in original form is called raw data. In visual series, the arrangement of raw data individually, it can be expressed in two ways: alphabetical arrangement, alphabetical or order, or array. It could be ascending or descending order. Then can be on the basis of frequency distribution. Frequency distribution means it refers to table in which observed value of a variable are classified according to their numerical magnitude. Means there are two types basically, discrete series, continuous series. पढ़ाए हमने इसके बारे में. Continuous values कौन सी होती हैं? If it can take any value in a given range, any value, like if I talk about 5.5, 5.6, it can take any value. And discrete, they are always in whole numbers. Like if we talk about number like how many years old are you, so if you are saying 20, that is a whole number, you are not telling it in fractions. So a discrete variable is discrete if the variable can take only some particular values or the whole values. And continuous series, it can take the fractional part also. Okay, now there are some terms used in these series. Class, each given internal interval is called class, like 0 to 5, 5 to 10, this is called class interval. Class limit is always having upper limit and lower limit. Upper limit, if we take this interval, upper limit is 10, lower limit is 5. Upper limit is 5, lower limit is 0. Then class interval, difference between upper limit and lower limit. Range, difference between upper limit and lower limit is called range. So if we calculate range of this, so 10 minus 5, 5, 5 minus 0, 5. Then midpoint or mid value. What is mid value? How it is calculated? Mid value is calculated as upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. By mistake it's written minus. It should be upper limit plus lower limit divided by 2. Then frequency. Frequency is the number of items falling within a particular class. Means how many times a thing has been repeated, that comes in the frequency. The next important topic in this chapter was exclusive series and inclusive series. Now exclusive series, what is exclusive series? excluding the upper limit of these classes, all the items of the classes are included in the class. See here, 0 to 10, 10 to 20. So what it means here, this upper class will be excluded here. Here only 0 to 9 values will be taken, and here 10 to 19 will be taken, and here 20 to 29 will be taken. So upper limit we have to exclude here in this exclusive series. Why? Because we cannot take a number at two places. 10 ko yahan bhi le lo, yahan bhi le lo. It's not possible. Na? And what is inclusive series? Inclusive series means upper class limit of classes are included in the respective classes. How? Like 0 to 9 means 9 will be included here. The next will start from 10, 10 to 19, then 20 to 29. So this is exclusive series, this is inclusive series. It's quite important. Like it can come in theoretical question as well as questions can also come on based on this. Then open-end classes. Open-end classes kaun se hote hain? Which are not having any like below limit and the upper limit. Like here we are writing below 20. How much below 20? Nothing is specified. So it's an open-end series. Similarly, for the last value also, last value here 50 and above. 50 and above means no limit, any value can be there. Okay, so this is called open-end series. Now cumulative frequency series. Cumulative frequency, when we are adding up the frequencies, that is called cumulative frequency. It is obtained by successively adding the frequencies of the values of the classes according to a certain law. The next is less than cumulative frequency. The frequency of each class interval are added successively. More than cumulative frequency. More than cumulative frequency is obtained by finding the cumulative total of frequencies starting from the highest value of the variable to the lowest. Now here it's like some questions have been discussed which are important, like what is meant by classification of data, what is meant by discrete series, inclusive series, exclusive series, continuous series. These all are important in this chapter. This was there inside this chapter. Apart from this, when you are studying from TR Gen book, there are some NCERT question and other things also. So go through that properly, learn that properly. It was just a overview of the chapter. Again, I took it so that if you have forgotten the concept, so that I can make your concepts clear. Okay, learning you will do from the book, whole chapter you will do. Okay, it was just a brief summary. Now I'll revise that presentation of data. What is presentation of data? We will open that. Presentation of data, it's having 2-3 chapters, but in this UT only this chapter 5 will be coming, which is chapter 5 in your TR Gen book. In stats only that chapter 5 will be coming over there. You will get questions out of that. Okay, so now presentation of data, important terms in this. What is presentation of data? First of all, when we are arranging data according to some category or some features of that data, that is called presentation. And when we are when we are showing it in the form of graphs, charts, column bars, frequency polygons, then this is called presentation of data. Okay, so important terms and concepts relating to presentation of data are, first one is tabulation. Orderly arrangement of data in rows and columns is called tabulation. See, data is stored or textual form hota hai data ka hamesha. So textual data jo hota hai, that is really very much tough to understand. So we present that data in a simple form, in the form of tables. Okay, and this tabulation means orderly arrangement of data in rows and columns. नाउ ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टैबुलेशन, क्यों करते हैं टैबुलेशन हम, क्या रीजंस हैं उसके पीछे. फर्स्ट वन इज इट हेल्प्स इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग एंड इंटरप्रेटिंग द डेटा इजीली. दूसरा इट हेल्प्स इन कंपेयरिंग डेटा. इट सेव्स स्पेस एंड टाइम. टैबुलेटेड डेटा कैन बी इजीली प्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ डायग्राम्स एंड ग्राफ्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट इज टेबल. टेक्सचुअल डेटा इज प्रेजेंटेड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ टेबल. सो मेन पार्ट्स ऑफ टेबल, दिस टेबल इज क्वाइट इम्पॉर्टेंट. ऑल द कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ दिस टेबल एंड द फॉर्मेट ऑफ टेबल इज क्वाइट इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो फर्स्ट मेन पार्ट ऑफ टेबल इज टाइटल ऑफ द टेबल. वॉट इट शोज, इट शोज अ ब्रीफ एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ कंटेंट्स ऑफ द टेबल. मीन्स टेबल के अंदर क्या कंटेंट्स हैं, इट इज इट कम्स इन द टाइटल ऑफ द टेबल. Suppose we are scoring marks of students, then title should be students marks or student result. Okay, then second is table number. So every table is given a table number. What is that table number? It is given for reference, like which table number is this. Then captions, a word or phrase which explains the content of a column of a table, that is called caption, means column heading. Okay. Stubs explain contents of row of a table. So row heading, we can say those are called stubs. Then body of the table, most important part of table as it contains all the data. Okay. Head note is inserted to convey complete information of title. Like title only shows a short information like what this table is storing, but head note, it is inserted to convey the complete information about title. Then G, source note refers to the source from which information has been taken. When we are making a table, below given is the format. I'll just scroll the screen to show you. See, we write ref source note also. See here at the bottom you can see source note. Here you can see source note, footnote. Source note means from where this data in the table has been taken. We have to acknowledge the source in the source note. Okay. Then footnote, it is used for pointing exceptions to the date. Means if there are any special exceptions in the data, then it is shown using footnote. Now we will do the format of table. Now this format of table, you have to practice it by drawing it, okay, with the help of scale and pencil. Do practice of drawing this table. Table number, title, then head note, it will come at the top. Okay, then here title we have discussed. Okay, then stub is row heading. Okay, then these are subheadings. Caption is column heading. This is column, these are columns, these four are columns, and these two, three are rows. One is stub, second stub entry, then column. So this is called body of the table. So this is the format of the table. How this table is made, this is called format of table. Then source note, as we discussed above, source note, here we will write like from where this data which is there inside the table, from where that data has been taken. So that we write in the source note. And then if there are some exceptions for the data, then that is written in the footnote. Now types of table. How many types of table are there that we will discuss? Types of table are simple table. Data are presented according to the characteristics only. Then there are double table. Data are presented about two interrelated characteristics of a particular variable. Then three-way table. Okay. then this manifold table. Okay, then next topic, this diagrammatic presentation of data or bar diagrams and pie diagrams. This is chapter 6 on in your book. I have not taken that in UT2, though we have covered it, but we will take it in next exam. Only chapter 4 and 5 from your TRGen book I have taken up in UT2, and that I have just discussed briefly. First it was organization of data, second it was presentation of data, and in presentation of data we have done only this textual presentation is done in the form of tables. We did the format of table. Okay, so this is all from this stats book. These two chapters are coming. Prepare them well for your UT2 exam. That microeconomics we will do in another video. This is all for today. Thank you.